hours, people. This is a cute little horsey video. Somebody sent me this and said they were feeding, or I forgot what she said she was doing. These horses are too stinking cute. So I can't even remember if she told me what she thought they were doing and she wanted my opinion or whatever. But when I looked at the video, I was like, that's a pretty cute little video. So let's talk about it. All right. So we've got some horses running around. Let me see if I can stop this with a... Oh, I can't. Good. So I can use my little space bar. All right. So what's going on here? We've got obviously some excitement. We've got some posturing, some running, some bucking, some confusion. Everything's going crazy. Oh my God, these horses are out of control. Separate them. They're going to fight. They're going to hurt each other. I'm surprised somebody isn't out there flying around with a broom. I got to save the horses. Oh, hang on. Let me mute the volume on here. So hopefully you can hear me. So what's going on? I mean, look, I'm not trying to be some super, I'm mystically connected with horses and I know what they're doing. I'm just observing these guys saying, hey, what are they doing? What's going on? What are the outside factors, inside factors? What can he cause? This little guy's kick was freaking cute. Did you see his little kick? Watch this. Here he is. Yeah! All right. So a lot of dynamics. We have five different horses and these two seem to be engaged in the most interaction. Man, what a great cutoff of the drive line. So, and these little guys look young and playful. They're just like, oh my God, everybody's running. Everybody's excited. Let's run too. This mare almost looks, or I say mare, I don't know. This horse right here almost looks a little old and moving slower. Doesn't want to really be involved. This one's really bucking. And I'm not sure why. Again, without knowing what happened before and what happened after, it's hard to tell. So, let's see here. If you notice, all the horses have nice manes, except this new one. I'm saying new. Maybe it isn't new. So, this horse right here is really trying to make an impression on this horse. This horse looks like a gelding. I don't know if it's gelding or mare. If I had to guess, if it's a mare, this gelding is trying to dominate and say, hey, I'm the high horse, whatever. If they're both geldings, this horse is trying to say, hey, I'm the high horse here. I'm going to move your feet and dominate you. If they're both geldings, this gelding is pushing back saying, hey, you can't move me. I'm tired of running. I'm just going to put my butt to you. I'm not going to run from you. So, and these guys, I think, are just kind of reacting to these guys having a disagreement. So I think the main focus here, if I had to guess, this would be a new horse. One, the mane is very trimmed and cut. It looks pretty well fed. I mean, all the horses look pretty well fed. I would just, if I had to guess, I would say this is a new horse. I could be totally wrong. And because it's a new horse, there's this herd dynamics that's going on that this guy's like, hey, this is my herd. I'm used to having my way. I got to move you around for one to show all the other horses that I'm really a high horse. They need to respect me because horses are watching. They're always learning. I always tell people that you go out to horse, you let horses chase you around and disrespect, and you go, well, it's not my horse and I had to carry it and he came over and tried to kick it and he wasn't my horse and I didn't want to correct him. All horses are watching and learning that, oh, if this horse can kick you or do something, then maybe I can be higher than you too. So this horse is looking, and if this horse dominates this horse may go, hey, I'm going to try that too because I may be higher. So looking at a nice little frog there, good hoof. Anyway, here we go. Okay, so they got tired of running. These guys are like looking. Again, this guy's, I would say this is a younger gelding and he's trying to learn. He's looking at this guy as, hey, this is the leader. This is the high gelding. Again, gelding and mares, I don't know. Somebody's going to come here and try to point out at some frame because they have nothing to do but watch and they're not really looking at everything, trying to explain everything. So they're going to go, you can see clearly that he's not a gelding and he's not a mare and you don't even know what you're... There's just so many barn witches that just fly around the internet looking for a place to spread their venom. So anyway, gelding or mare doesn't really matter. I'm just trying to explain kind of what's going on with the dynamics from my opinion, from my limited knowledge. I know nothing other than what I'm seeing. So I could be totally wrong, people, but you can pick up certain things after dealing and watching horses over the years. That's kind of like, why is this horse doing this? And we kind of guess and we think that's why. It could be wrong, but through years of watching them, if you're right more than you are wrong, then in court, you're considered an expert. I mean, in court, to testify as an expert in a criminal trial to put someone in prison, an expert only has to have more knowledge than the average person. That's a pretty low standard for expert. In a horse world, to be an expert, all you have to do is own a broom and a halter and a rope and a whip and some nice shiny boots and nice tight tan pants, and you're an expert in a horse field. In court, you just need more knowledge than the average person. So here we go. So the excitement is kind of worn down a little bit. These two horses are both yielding at this guy. Automatic. He's not necessarily pushing them. They are both yielding in unison almost exactly like, hey, high horse is coming. It's our job to yield. We don't push him. He gets to chase horses around. He shouldn't have to chase us. I don't want to be chased. Therefore, I'm going to get out of his way. They're learning. You need to act like a high horse. Horses should yield to you. You shouldn't have to ask. Horses should move out of your way. You shouldn't have to ask. You don't want to nag and beat them to where they're scared of you, but they need to know that, hey, you get to go where you want and do what you want, and we don't interfere with you. They're so cute. I mean, all these horses are just freaking darlings. I just love them. All right, so he's moving them a little bit, but he's not really chasing, but he is definitely moving. He is at the rear. This is where a lot of people say, the mare runs the herd, Rick, because the mare's always in front and they follow her. You lead from the rear by directing and controlling other horses' feet and movement. That's how you lead, okay? All right. So the two little ones got out of his way. This mare was, or this other gelding, this horse was relaxing. And he's like, okay, I got my breath. Let me go back and reinforce. This, now a lot of people will see this as bullying, and he's picking on this horse, and he won't let this horse relax. And why is he being a bull? He's not being a bully. He's being a horse that is showing dominance. And again, humans cause this behavior. And when we see it, we want to protect it and save it when in fact we caused it. This is happening because they're in a small enclosed box area. If they had room to give distance, this horse may stay outside of the herd. And this guy may just hang with the herd and would only push this horse if it tried to get in with the herd. When we lock a herd up, the horse can't show respect by staying away. It has no room. We have prevented this horse from being able to show the lead horse respect. So what does the lead horse see? This horse is being disrespectful. The lead horse doesn't say, I get it. You would probably be good and you're yielding and I'll leave you alone because the stupid humans locked us up in here and you can't give me release. He doesn't know that. He just knows, hey, I've told this horse to stay away from my herd and it's still with my herd. I mean, it's just amazing how people can turn things around and blame horses and try to save and claim that they're saving. And some, you know, if this horse did this, someone would run out there, grab his horse, put a halter and take it out and go, I had to save this horse. And now this horse loves me. And now it wants to follow me because I saved it. You didn't save it. You set it up to be saved. because you didn't know what you were doing, and now you want to make yourself seem important and smart and a savior, and you go in and take it out of the environment that you place it in and claim to everyone else that you saved it and you're the great horse whisperer that saved it. When actually you're just an idiot and you didn't even know, you don't even know what you don't know about causing what you're doing. This is all being caused because the horse is in it. Now, I'm not picking on the woman that did this video. She may take it personally. She may go, oh man, I sent him this video and now he's making me look like an idiot. This may be, she has to lock it up. There could be reasons. Maybe they were free and she put it in there. She puts them in there 2 hours a day. I don't know. I'm just trying to give you guys a horseman's knowledge or experience on what I see and what I think's going on. I could be 100% wrong. I don't think I am. And even if I am wrong about who's the mare and who's the horse and who, even if I'm wrong about that, I'm not wrong about what this horse and this horse is trying to do. This horse is trying to show this horse, you're in my area, I'm higher and you're lower. You must yield to me. I can make your feet move. I, as lead horse, can't control where you go and where you stand. I get to decide if you get to stand with us or if I can chase you and make you move and wear you out. I make the decisions, and by making all the decisions, you must recognize me as the high horse. I'm not wrong about that. I may be wrong about some things, but I'm not wrong about that. All right, here we go. And I don't like people that put things in and things. I mean, a lot of horse people do things like this. I want to put a log out there so my horses have to jump over something. Is it bad? I don't know if it's bad. Does it make a horse have obstacles? Yeah. When you put horses in flat areas all the time and they never have to watch their feet or look at obstacles, sometimes they will get clumsy. Sometimes they don't pay attention to footing. So by putting a tire or a wood or something in an area, does it make the horse kind of pay attention? Do they have to jump over it sometime and move? They do. Is that a bad thing? No. Can a horse, when he's getting chased, trip over this and hurt himself? Yes. Do you want to make your horse area so safe so your horses? It depends. I mean, again, you've got 5 horses in a what I consider a very small area. I mean, I think this area is too small to keep 1 horse in. You notice there's no grass. It's all dirt. When you see dirt and horses, the land cannot support the animals. That's because people who are running or having animals don't get it. They get too many animals and they don't realize that when you see dirt with horses or any other animals, you have too many animals and the land can't sustain the regrowth and the tearing down. I have 10 acres with 2 horses. And I still get a few dirt areas, not the whole pasture. I get dirt areas because that's where the horses like to stand. They communicate with the other horses. So I have worn down areas in my 10 acres with only 2 horses because that's where they like to stand. When you put horses in small areas 24/7, you're going to get dirt and mud. It's not good for the horses. You're going to get bacteria. You're going to have a lot of urine. You're going to have a lot of crap. Horse poop everywhere, and that's going to be bad for your horse's feet. It's just all bad. Anyway, here we go. This little guy is so stinking cute. Who doesn't want to go hug this little guy and give him a great big kiss on that nose? What a stinking cute little baby. Oh my God, he's so stinking cute. He's looking at who's ever filming. He's like, Mom, what's going on? Save me. Get me out of here. All right. So if we notice in the background here, this horse has showed his butt to the horse he was chasing. Is he threatening to kick him? Is he being mean? No, it's kind of a disrespectful or a lack of threat. This horse is saying, this horse, you don't concern me. I can walk away from you. I get to choose where I want to go. And so, I mean, are they really saying this? I'm just trying to explain kind of what's going on. I don't think these 2 horses are thinking this, so to speak, but it's just a behavior talk. So it almost looked like this. Oh, this horse is going to lay down, which again kind of tells me this horse is new. Now, when a horse comes in and lays down in another horse's area, sometimes a horse will take this as a disrespect, because laying down is kind of showing confidence and comfort. Laying down is kind of showing, I don't feel threatened. I'm confident. I can lay down. I'm strong. I can get up. I can fight off anything. So this laying down, although it may not be to show disrespect, it can be perceived as disrespect to the high horse, because this horse is not showing this horse, so to speak, the respect he desires. You shouldn't lay down unless I let you lay down. You shouldn't get relaxed unless I let you relax. If I'm the high horse, I should be able to put pressure on you, and you shouldn't feel this comfortable. If you feel this comfortable, I must not be doing my job as a high horse. Meanwhile, this horse like, dude, can I get a carrot? All right, here we go. So this horse is like, damn, this horse laid down and rolled. Now, this horse could be saying, you know what? I'll let you chase me around and I'll move and yield, but I'm not too afraid of you that I can't lay down and roll. This horse, being a new horse, new horses like to roll in new areas. They get the scent of the area. They become part of the herd. They put their scent in the area. They blend into the area for predators so they don't smell. You know, moms will lick their babies so they don't smell like afterbirth and blood to attract predators. This, getting the smell of all the other horses, gets you accepted to the herd, and it makes you smell like the environment so you don't stand out, so a predator can't say, what's this new fresh meat I smell in this area? So there's a lot of things for rolling here. All these horses are pretty muddy, like they like to roll. All right, so we're rolling. This horse really isn't being offended by this. He's allowing this. He's like, okay. Could he stop this? Absolutely. If he wanted to go over there and start backing up this horse would feel threatened and jump up and either run off or kick him or bite him. But he's not doing that. Is he not doing that because he's not threatened by this? Is he not doing this because he's confused that, damn, maybe this horse is strong and doesn't really worry about me. Maybe I ought to be careful. Maybe I shouldn't push it. Maybe. We'll see. I mean, I watched this when I watched it a couple times just because they were so cute. And I really haven't stopped and evaluated it frame by frame like this to kind of see what's going on. You are so stinking cute. All right. So I'm not doing this frame by frame. This videotape, I think, is just when you sent this, I mean, it looks that way. I'll play it through at the end so you can watch it. But all right. So I'm saying she because I think I might have heard her voice or something. I think she did something here to make them move. Like, get out of the way. We're trying to see what's going on. And they both kind of said, oh, mom told us to move. We got to move. So I always kind of look, if I pause, I'm always looking at horses' feet, looking at the angles. These horses look like they got good angles and nice feet. I don't see any flaring. I don't see a lot of chipping. I don't see horseshoes. So I like this. I do see a lot of dirt and mud, and where they're being fed on top of this mud, you see fresh hay. So they're being fed in this. I don't like that. And unfortunately, when you send me a video, I'm going to crack on things that I don't like seeing. People crack on me because I have barbed wire. You know what? The fence was here. I have, I don't know how many thousand feet of fence. There's no way I could afford to replace it. Plus, I'm surrounded by cattle. And if I don't have barbed wire, cattle will just tear down the fence. So if you have cattle next to you and you don't have barbed wire, they're going to tear down your fence. But anyway, I digress. So I don't like this muddy, and I don't like feeding on top of mud and dirt. But these horses seem to be rolling in it. And if you keep horses in mud and swine and swallow, they will get used to looking like this, and it will become normal. I did a video, and I don't know if I posted it yet, where when it was cold, I had to remove the poop out of my horse's stall. And I said, anytime a horse is pooping a stall, I remove it as fast as I can. I do not want my horses to think it's okay to stand in around their crap. They only poop in a stall when it's really, really cold or raining, and they don't want to go out to poop. So they'll stand in there out of the rain and elements and out of the wind, and they end up pooping. And then they end up walking in it and standing in it and smelling it. And I don't like that. I don't want them to think that's normal. In the wild, that's never normal. Horses never roll in their urine and poop. Now, if they're trying to dominate or get a smell or blend in, they may do it, but it is not normal and routine for horses to roll. They roll in dirt and dust, and maybe they'll roll in mud from a pond to get the flies off of them or to get some sun protection, but they do not roll in their urine and crap and stinky crap in the wild. They only do that when people lock them up to where they have no choice. All right? So here comes the high gelding. You see him running in the background here. Let me go back and get... He's relaxed. These guys are relaxed. Let's watch him come barreling in here like, I got to control. People are ignoring me. They're looking at mom. What's going on? And here he comes. What's going on? This is Mr. Busybody. This is Mr. High Horse. Actually, I don't know if this is High Horse. See, there's different types of high horses. There are high horses that nag and run and have to be and always explain and show everybody how high they are. These are the naggers that I see women walking around. Get out of my space. Respect my space. Don't you come up on me. Give me my bubble. You don't want to approach me unless I tell you. I'm going to chase you off. I'm going to show you who's boss. Those are the nagger that type leaders that are always screaming. Your confident, good leaders like Mr. T was, he just eludes strength and respect by the way he walks. He walks in. He doesn't have to show anybody he's boss. He does what he needs to do. If somebody doesn't yield, he moves them with a little bit of pressure or a little ear pin, and he tells them to move. And if they don't, then he bites them and says, hey, I warned you, you need to pay attention to me. And it's over. He doesn't chase and nag and you got to listen to me and I got to show everybody how strong I am. You know, the only time he does that is if he's challenged or if he's fighting a mare. And I don't, again, I don't know whether we got mares and geldings in this mix here. I have looked and looked and I cannot pause it enough to see if this guy is a gelding. I'm assuming he is. I don't know if they're all geldings, all mares, again. So that horse is really getting a good mud roll. Here comes the other little horse coming in. It looks like they're being drawn in by mom, who is filming. And again, they associate with treat. My horse associate me with treats and food. I mean, that's just normal. So they're coming in to see her standing by the gate. She's creating this draw. Notice how all the horses are gathering around her. That's why you don't want to create draws in corners, because horses can't roll out. That's why it's better to have round, no corners and only round in all places. That's why a round pen is so effective. You can't trap a horse. Round pens are for people that are too stupid to work a horse in a corner and understand pressure and release. People that round pen, if you put them in a square pen and tell them to lunge, if they don't know what they're doing, they will trap a horse and they will make it jump over the fence and corner and rear and charge and do all kind of crazy things. So the round pen is a crutch for most people because it makes it easy, and the horse only has one option to continue to move. He can't go to a corner and look for release. All right, here we go. Oh, as soon as this horse was coming in, and again, the horse may have jumped up. Let me see how it gets up. Let's watch this horse get up in the background. Because it may jump up and buck and show strength. It did. It took off. See it run? It took off. It did. I call it the Bucking Buddy Show. When Buddy rolls, he jumps up, bucks, and runs really fast and shows strength. Well, when he did this, this horse reacted and said, oh, hell, here we go. We're on again. Looking at his little feet here. So, feet look pretty good. And again, this horse... The very flashy, fast moving, the way this horse gets up, watch it. It's very hard to tell because the camera falls. I'm not going to do anything. Shake, jumps off. Whee! yee-haw, I'm free. And this horse goes, whoa, 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 this is my pasture. So what did this horse do? Change this horse's direction, move this horse where he wanted to go, didn't allow this horse to go where it wanted to. He changed the direction and showed dominance. These little guys are like, hey, what's going on? Let's watch the big dog. So these two both showing a lot of head nodding here, kind of talking. Watch this head nodding. Head up right here. Head look. Watch the head nodding. Kind of bucking. She almost, there's a head nodding. Turning, playing, kind of going sharp. Little threat here. Like, hey, don't push me. I'm pushing back. This can be disrespectful. It can be play. Watch this little buck. Get off me. Horse puts his head up, but he's still putting pressure. Still moving the horse. Horse kicked again. I don't know if you saw that. Watch this little horse kick right here. Kicked again. Pushing back. Making him do circles. Controlling him. This horse is saying, I'm tired of moving. Finally stops. Goes back. Head to head. Ooh. Got a little challenge here. Got like, I'm tired of running. You're not going to move me anymore. I'll let you move me a little bit because I'm new and I'm not sure. I'm done running. This is where a lot of people fail when they're working with horses. When they get this pushback, they get fearful or scareful and they stop and they show weakness. And the horse is like, oh, I got this person's number. This is when you, if you're really high horse, you need to pull the trigger and push back harder and go, no, no, you don't get to push back on me. And I think they're kind of playing right here. I'm not sure that they're really going for dominance. Nose to nose. That's why if I had to guess, this is a new horse. And they are working off new horsey issues. So now there's not pushing. Both standing their ground. Both facing each other. No higher and no lower. Now we're deciding who's higher and lower. Got a little paw action there. See that? Watch that pawing. I would say this is a mare because of the pawing, but I have seen geldings do that also. This little guy here. I bet you he's a pain. He's a buddy horse. He's got to be right in the middle. Hey, man, my contract says I'm the prettiest horse. You got to get me in a camera. Cute. All right, so that was the film. All right, I'm going to play it all the way through and let you guys just watch it. I'm not pausing. I'm not doing anything. I'll just talk in the background. Running, chasing, showing strength, having fun, getting exercise. Check it out. Oh, nice double barrel kick. Missed that earlier. Get off me. Another double barrel from that one. Double up. Oh, little bite. Circle, circle. Pressure, 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 pressure. Move, move, move. I don't want to move. Pressure, pressure, pressure. Pushing back, pushing back. Pressure, pressure, pressure. Keeping her butt, showing strength, not yielding. Okay, I'll run. Yay, I'll chase. Kick, pressure, pressure, pressure. Stop. Stop. Running, running, running. Pressure, release. Pressure, 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 release. No release. Pressure back, pressure back, pressure back. Listen to me. I'm a high horse. I'm going to make you move. I'm going to harass you. You can't make me stop. I'm going to keep putting pressure until you run. I'm going to turn. I'm going to bite. I'm going to kick. Stop chasing me. Two little guys. Yay! What's going on? Everybody's running. Let's run and chase too. Kicking, kicking. So this is the horse with the mane. These are, oh, look, right there. Oh, man, I love that. I said I wasn't going to pause it, but I really love that little action. Watch this horse show dominance and speed and cut off that drive line. Great example of cutting off that drive line. This other horse is in front and showing I'm running. I'm going to cut you off. Ah, cut off that drive line. I stopped your movement. I'm stronger. I'm higher. Woo! Nice. Nice. So that's the other little chestnut with the nice mane. So that could be the lead horse or strong horse. Lots of activity, lots of things going on. I was just trying to focus on the two that were most kind of interacting. Uh, Stop! Stop! Save him! He's gonna kill him! Somebody go get a rope! We gotta separate him! Oh my god, they're gonna hurt each other! And they might kick each other and... Oh no! They should have halters on so we can catch him easier! What are we gonna do? Two little guys. Oh, we got... Don't get too close. They'll chase us. Very cute little herd. Nice little dynamics. Another thing I wanted to point out here. Rick, you said you weren't going to stop it. Yeah, well, you know what? I get to do what I want because I'm making the freaking video. All right, another problem you have when you keep horses in area is horses pack down and beat down. Just like they do at gates. Gates will always get dropped. Therefore, they collect water. It turns into mud. Horses walk through the mud. The mud collects to the feet. They drag off dirt and the hole gets bigger. And then it collects more water. And then it turns into more mud. Then horses walk through. They collect mud on their feet. And then as they walk through, the mud falls off. But they pull dirt and mud from an area and the hole gets bigger. It's a mud hole. This is what happens in this whole area. Notice how they have packed down and you have a little ledge right here of losing dirt. Dirt has been packed down and carried away from the feet over running and running and packing and running. And now you have this little ledge. And this is part of pasture management that happens when you have too many horses in a small area. You get this. It's going to happen. It happens at gates. It happens at any walkways. It happens at stalls. You have to replace dirt because it's constantly either being packed or carried off on the horse's feet in the mud and water. Not to mention when it rains, it runs off. You have runoff. You have all kind of things. Pasture management gets much harder when you have more horses or too many horses in small areas. All right. I said I was going to let it run. Let me try it again. I'll drink some coffee. Hi, buddy. Hi. Hi, cutie. What a cute little, little eyelashes. Little blonde eyelashes. Cute. Nice rolling the hay, rolling the mud. Stretch the back out. Get some smells, bug protection, sun protection. Stretch out the old joints. Those little whiskers on those horses. I don't see any bad stuff except the new horse has a trim mane. I don't really like that. I didn't see if it has whiskers or not. I'd have to go back through and see if that horse with the shaved mane has whiskers. I like horses that are natural with whiskers and manes and hair, and it doesn't have to be straight or combed. Okay, I don't really like this cut tail here either. This is not natural. So, not a fan of that. Rick, you said you weren't going to stop it. I know, but I'm seeing other things. Let your damn horses grow tail the way they want it. Why people got to be trimming and shit? Is that another log out there? Shit, I didn't even see this damn log. There's no log in the pasture. This could be for water runoff, drainage, redirecting water. I don't know if this is just what people think. You know, I see cones over here, probably making them run circles or do cones or whatever, but logs left in the middle are normally, you know, people go, my horse needs to learn how to jump and he's scared of logs. And when I take him for a ride, he won't go over anything. And it's not the log and it's not that he doesn't know. It's that he doesn't respect you and he knows that you won't make him go over something. So he balks at it and then you go around it. Rick, you said you weren't going to stop it and all right, here we go. I'm sorry. Not really, but I'll just say it just to appease somebody and make them feel good so they'll stop crying. Okay, so the shaved mane horsey has a cut tail too. I'm wondering if he's got whiskers. Let me go back through here. Is there a close-up of this horsey? Does it do a drive-by? No, I think most of the footage on this horse. Oh, here we go. Maybe we got some footage here. Does it have whiskers? You know what? It does look like it's got its little shaved whiskers. But this one does too, and I think he has whiskers. So maybe we just can't see it. If it doesn't have its whiskers, I don't like it. Ow! And you notice this horse isn't biting. He's just kind of showing his teeth. He's kind of trying to bite, and the horse like, hey, and the horse is moving away as he's putting pressure so he doesn't get bit. If this horse didn't move away, he may be able to grab some skin and pinch a good bite. But because, you know, it's kind of hard. Horses' teeth are straight up and down, so it's hard for them to bite unless you stick your fingers in it and then blame the horse for trying to bite you. Horses, if you keep things flat, they really can't bite. But anyway, all right, shit, 35 minutes. Holy cow. I'm going to get some hate. Some people will like it. Y'all have a good one. Hopefully you enjoyed the horsey thing, and we'll end that there. Buddy Miss T, Ransom, you're good boys.